I'm Tyler.
Logan.
And Jordan's helping us out from home. Today we're going over our level one class sheet so that you guys who started a beginner's class with us can sort of get a grasp on what we covered, since we didn't actually get a chance to go everything. So by the time we get back into class, you'll know what we're gonna do, and if you took the time to actually practice some of this, you'll get a head start too. Let's get to it.
All right, so first thing on the list in level one is landings, all right? It's the first thing we do in every class. So let's go through the basics. Number one, how do we land? Really simple, it's the way our foot hits the floor and then the way we use our legs, that's most important. So always wanna aim to land toe, ball, and then lower ourselves down into the heel, bending in the knee, the ankle, and the hips all together. Try and keep your posture nice and straight while you do it. So, once we know how that works, we practice the different kind of landings we'll be using. Starting with a forward landing, then into a sideways landing, then into a backwards landing, okay? So find a nice box like this, just like you did in class. Nice simple hop, 2 foot controlled landing. Next one we're gonna do, scoot landing. What's a scoot landing? It's basically just a different technique you're gonna use when you have too much momentum going forward to just stick that 2 foot landing, okay? So it's gonna involve the hands a little bit. Prerequisite to this is your monkey runs on the floor, okay? So getting down on the balls of your feet like this, reaching your hands out. You gotta put all the weight on the hands and then move the feet, okay? The feet have to move, the hands have to stay, okay? They can't move at the same time. So, once you got that down, all it is, get up on the box, jump a little further out this time so you have more momentum, and then as you land, nice little scoot. Okay, so, next one, drop down from a hang. Basically, all this is gonna be is a nice way to get down if you're hanging on like the edge of a fence, maybe you did a wall run and now you're up there and you need to come down, maybe you're climbing on your treehouse, I don't know. But what it's gonna do is it's gonna save you from scraping down the side of it or landing funny, hurting your ankles, stuff like that. So when we're on the wall, nice cat hang, got our feet on the wall, all you wanna try and do is look down to spot your landing, and you're gonna wanna make sure you push off the wall a little bit so you get away from it so we avoid the scraping. So all I'm gonna do here, push off the top foot, land on the ground.
Now we have the dash down from sitting. This is a safe way to get down from an edge that might be a little bit higher than you're comfortable jumping off of, and it's really simple. All you have to do is put your hands down on whatever you're sitting on, push away and put your legs out in front of you, and land. Bend your knees to absorb, and you're good to go. Now we're moving on to the first jump, which is called the precision. Precision is a 2 foot landing on any object. So it could be a line on your floor, it could be a towel, or it could even be like a curb on a sidewalk, something like that. What you're going to do is come up to whatever you're jumping to, line it up, make sure you're not jumping too far. You don't want to overdo it. You're going to jump, land on your object with your feet together. You're going to bend your knees to absorb. Don't bend your back, but bend your knees and keep your back straight instead. Bend your knees, keep your back straight, put your arms on in front of you to balance, and then absorb.
So running freeze, we're gonna be doing a 1 foot takeoff, landing on 2 feet on our toes, sticking it. This one you're gonna wanna practice with a left foot takeoff and a right foot takeoff. So it's 1 foot takeoff, 2 foot landing.
Okay, so for step vaults, we're gonna be using one hand and your opposite foot, planting them solidly on whatever you're vaulting, in my case, some chairs. Make a gap in between your hand and feet and step your other leg through that gap. This is one that's important that you practice with both your left hand and right foot and your right hand and left foot so you can get it on both sides.
Even if you don't have a vault, you can practice this on the floor, same thing, foot, hand, through the gap in the middle, get used to that motion.
So once you've got your step vault down on both your left side and your right side, if you happen to have a picnic table like me, you can try a bit of a trickier challenge by combining them. So we're going to do one left side step vault and then one right side step vault, descending down the two tiers. I'll show you.
This next one is called the speed vault. This one is used for getting over a vault box or a wall or any object really fast. What you're going to do, starting in a straight line, run up to your object. You're going to put one hand down, and the leg on the same side as the hand you just put down is going to kick across your body. It's going to turn your body slightly to the side so that your legs Avoid the box. That's the number one thing here. You want to get your legs nice and high so that your knee or your shin don't clip. Look something like this.
Lazy vaults. What's new, what's different, what's the same? Same thing, we're still going from one side to the other. What's new is the way we're doing it. We're not going straight anymore like all the other vaults. Number one, you wanna curve in from an angle. But which way do you curve? It depends which hand you're starting with. If you're starting with right hand, you wanna curve out from the right. Start with left hand, curve out to the left, okay? So as I come in, step one is curve. Step two, hand plant. Step three, kick the leg. The kick is everything in this vault, okay? It's gonna get you all your power, and it's gonna get you all your control. It's gonna get you from one side to the other. So step three, big kick. Step four, hand goes down. Nice slap, nice push, okay? Let's go through it one more time, all the steps. Step one, curve to the side. Step two, hand. Step three, kick. Step four, push. So, we're gonna go over turn vaults now. This is gonna be a little bit new to some of you if you're in one of our older sessions, okay? It's sort of new to the curriculum. All it is a good way to vault over an obstacle, but say we don't wanna keep going and running out the other side. We wanna turn around and land still holding on to it. So the way it's gonna work, you're gonna put a hand on like this. If I'm turning left, it's my left hand. If I'm turning right, my right hand goes on like this, okay? So I'm gonna go left for this demo. As I jump up, I'm gonna reach the other hand all the way across, so it's gonna hit just like the first one, okay? So I'm starting here, big jump. They both grab on, and now I'm stuck here. I'm landing 2 feet, facing where I came from, and I'm not going anywhere, okay? It's gonna be really useful on little walls or railings, okay? Railings is a big one for this one.
All right, so for basic swing, most people aren't gonna have like a bar in their house or anything like that. I found a nice tree branch, made sure it's thick enough that I can hang on it without breaking it or anything like that. For this one, we're gonna do grip with thumbs over top because it's a bit of a bigger surface. Generate a bit of swing just by putting your legs out in front, letting your arms stay nice and long, no need to pull yourself in. If you need to, you can readjust on the back swing to make it a little bit more comfortable. Dismounting on the back, nice and safe, you can spot your landing.
So now that we've learned how to gather momentum on the bar, we need to learn how to get down safely as well. So once you gather the momentum, you point your toes, look down at your feet, and then let go. That's it.
All right, so we know how to generate swing, and we know how to dismount backwards at this point. But what happens if you want to dismount going forwards? Well, you need a move called a lache. So how does a lache work? Pretty simple, you get your momentum going. So I'm swinging on this bar. Step one, kick your feet where you want to go. You gotta kick those things and they're gonna send you forward and they're gonna get you some height in the air. But there's one other thing that they're gonna do. They're gonna tip you backwards. So how do we counteract that and make sure we land upright? Very simple, very important. You have to pull that bar as you swing forward and throw it behind you, okay? So a good way to practice, might be a little limited at these times being at home and whatnot, but if you have a bar around yay height, maybe on a playground or on a tree or something, you get hanging on it so your heels are on the floor, and then all you gotta do is pull hard enough that you stand up, okay? That's the motion. Thank you.